Now is the time to come together, to stand together as citizens of India and say, hey, you know what, government, we're not going to let you use a crisis of such devastating and gigantic proportions to pass a law that says it will help Indian citizens, but is really benefiting the government and private companies more. Whether you're bantering on WhatsApp or ordering biryani from Zomato, giving an online exam, getting a COVID test done, throughout your day, little bits of your life get stored as data. Think about the migrant worker who needs access to his ration but may not even have a smartphone which he can use for biometric scans and authentication. Today, our lives are controlled by personal data, and of course, we need to protect this data from getting into just anybody's hands. So there is a new proposed law which seeks to protect our data and hence protect our rights. The incoming law helps authorities make decisions about how your data is governed. So they do this by slotting us into three categories. The first is you, the person who actually owns the data. The second is Facebook, Google, government bodies, etc., who store the data. And the third is people like health providers or advertisers who use this data. The information about you that they're looking to regulate is your finances, health data, name, number, email, sex and sexuality, are you trans, are you intersex, your political beliefs, your caste, your tribe, your religion, your DNA, iris, fingerprint, essentially anything that can be used to identify you, which is what we call personal data or sensitive personal data. Now, in theory, the bill really emphasizes consent. It says that you have the right to know what's being done with your data, and you can tell any of these entities that you don't want them to process your data anymore. You can withdraw your consent. If somebody like Facebook wants to collect your data, they have to tell you why. If a data breach has happened, you have to be informed. And in all of these things, your privacy has to be centered. But of course, in reality, there is a long list of issues. Imagine you want to withdraw your consent. You don't want somebody to process your data anymore. You have to give a valid reason, otherwise you'll face legal consequences. And we're not sure what exactly valid is or what the consequences might be. And you also have to pay money to do this. You have to pay a fee to do this, which might disincentivize a lot of people from exercising their rights, and it may just not be accessible for them. There are also some situations where your data can be used without your consent. For example, for the government to give you services, like for example, voter verification or application of the RTI law. Now, it is true that sometimes our personal information is genuinely helpful in the larger public interest, but the problem here is there are very few checks and balances in this regard. And for intelligence agencies and law enforcement, the provisions of the Act will largely not apply to them. So they will continue having unhindered access to our data, like our phone calls, and so much more. This is to say that once again, the government will be given large allowances that allow them to impinge on our rights, like our right to privacy, in the name of national security and public order. And then, like, you go to work every day, right? Or at least you're working from home every day. Your employer will have access to your personal data without your consent. So get ready to feel like you're constantly being monitored and surveilled, which is a really stressful working environment. The bill also gives us some reasonable purposes for which our consent is not required. One such reasonable purpose is to use our data if it's publicly available. Now think about how much of yourself is publicly available out there. This means that the state and private companies may potentially start processing this data to discriminate on political or religious grounds, or for political advertisement, or for profiling, etc. Now, another interesting thing, and this is particularly relevant to you because you're watching this video on social media, the bill will start off the process for you to voluntarily verify your identity on social media platforms. It's kind of like a blue tick, but for everyone, to say that, yeah, I am the actual person behind this account. Now, imagine you give your Aadhaar to verify your identity, and now the people from the back end have even more sensitive personal information about you to create a 360 degree profile on you, which is just eerie. And in a way, this will make you lose your anonymity on the internet, and it's going to be damn hard to get back once it's gone. One of the biggest problems people see is that there is a data protection authority which is supposed to protect and determine your rights. This is an authoritative body and it's supposed to be working in your interest. But it's not independent in its appointment. It's literally bound by the directions of the central government. So who will protect your rights? Literally in a bill whose purpose is to do that. It just doesn't make any sense. Now, I know it may seem like we're already at the point of no return and we'll never have a good data protection law, but that's not the case. We have to start putting pressure on our local MPs now. Now is the time, and it's a time to start raising this issue across public forums with your friends, with your family, in your schools and colleges, on your Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Talk about it. Just coming in here with a quick, honest and candid addendum. Things are really bad with COVID-19 in India right now. There's obviously a spike. And all of us at IFF just wanted to extend some warmth to you. And we hope you and your loved ones are doing okay. We ourselves are currently functioning at half capacity because our staff is sick, they're stressed. It's a bad time for India all around. The reason we talk about the Personal Data Protection Bill today is because the COVID-19 scenario in India itself has a lot to do with data protection. We started the year with Arogya Setu and its many security and privacy concerns. We now have COVID, we have the digitization of the vaccination process. Our whole health data ecosystem is just transforming in a big way. And it's going to be dangerous if this doesn't happen with a robust data protection legislation. If you have the bandwidth, please consider leading this conversation in your communities and championing this cause. You can check out Seva Privacy. It's a campaign under which IFF has been writing and fighting and litigating around the data bill and larger privacy concerns in India for a long time now. Check out those resources. Let us know how else we can help you advocate for your own rights in these trying times and become an advocate for the cause of data protection and digital rights in India. This is the movement of the future.